Yo! Great, great Thursday evening on this dope-ass 13th day of January of 2022 in the year of the Most High and Majestic Source of All Life. Yo, it's a great day. You know what I'm saying? It's a great day. It's a great day. It's a great evening. It's a great ending to the day. I just stuffed my face. You know what I'm saying? I just stuffed my face like about an hour or so ago. Been eating late, man. Last few days since especially since starting back on this Muay Thai journey. Been eating late, been getting up late. I don't know what it is. I mean, usually be like this around winter time, man. Around winter time my discipline just wanes when it comes to waking up early, man. Got up today like around 9 or something like that. Had a dental appointment. Had some fillings done in my teeth. Wasn't able to eat all day, so that's one of the reasons why I ate late. So I literally didn't consume anything but my special tea blend of like 14 ingredients. Some water, and that's all I had literally from when I ate yesterday around 9 or 10 till today around 9, almost 10. So I went for about a 24 hour fast without even meaning to, or fast off of food because, you know, we were still drinking things. But yo, it's still a great day. We still managed to make it a great day. Went to my doctor appointment, or to the dentist appointment. Got things done by some wonderful ladies. You know what I'm saying? Came back, banged out my ritualistic 500 reps for the day. You know, they're like 50 push-ups, 50 pull-ups. I think I banged out 50 squats, 100 calf raises, maybe like 150 for abs, 50 dips, 50 hip thrusters. You know, that the regular. You know, this is just something that I just started doing this before the year ended. Something that I was doing all through November while I was involuntarily detained in Panama for, you know, 26 days. Out of the 30 that I was detained in Panama. So I came up with this ritual that I would do, you know, regularly when I would wake up. So I decided to apply it to my lifestyle. And I decided that I'm gonna make this a new lifestyle routine, you know, like reading, like writing, like meditating, like doing the breathing, the Wim Hof breathing exercises and all the other breathing exercises that I may learn on this path. We started doing that. You know, every day we bang out 500 reps. Whether we train or we don't train, we bang out the 500 reps. So got that done, you know. Finished the book the day before yesterday. And today I read yesterday's pages and today. So I read about 40 pages today. Or 20-something, maybe 30 pages today. Got my journaling done. You know, that's all it is, man. Daily just doing things. And around four, I went to my sister's house to vibe with my nieces and nephews. And I had my niece do a little something. As soon as I got to my sister's house, I told my little nephew, yo, go get me a blank piece of paper. And I told my little niece, Haley, I got something for you to do. And right before she started complaining, I was like, yo, what you complaining about? You don't even know what I got for you to do. And she was like, I was like, yo, I'm about to have you use your imagination. Soon as I said that, her mind was like, what you want me to do? So I sat her down and I just started giving her ideas. And I was like, I want you to fill out this paper back in front with as many ideas as you can come up, Haley. I want you to put as many ideas as you can come up with about what you want to do in life. Don't even worry about money. Don't worry about kid. Don't worry if you have money. Don't worry about being a kid or how old you are. I just want you to put down anything that you want to do. You know, you want to travel the world, you want to fly planes, you want to drive cars, you want to create apps, you want to make videos, you want to be movies, you want to dance, you want to sing, you want to be a mom, a grandma, an auntie, whatever it is, put it down. First thing she writes down. I saw it as I got up and like went about my business. I want to be a millionaire. I was like, yo. She was, and then she put down another one. She was like, I want to be an investor like Sosa. I'm like, yo, this little kid, yo. And she keeps going down the line. I wanna go mountain climbing. I want to travel. I want to be a flight attendant. I want to be a teacher. I want to make videos on YouTube. And I want to help. I'm like, yo. And she literally filled out back and front pages. And, you know, from there, I let her know, you know, that's good. You're using your imagination. I like that. Then she sees me. And she's looking at me. And I'm like, you done? And she's like, yeah. And I'm like, you sure? She's like, what do you think I'm doing over here? And she's like, on your phone? And I'm like, yeah, okay, what else? Posting stuff. So I go in over and I show her what I was writing. And it was something related to a post that I saw. And it was like, the post asked, if somebody gave you $1 billion, what would you do with that $1 billion? And I really, I literally wrote down a whole plan, a whole probably 20, 30 year plan of what I would do with $1 billion. And I literally said that I would buy about 15 properties of land around the world in some of the most poverty and war stricken countries around the world, to include America. You know, because even if we haven't had any war, we have had, you know, legalistic, political, governmental wars. You know, our streets being riddled with drugs and guns and just, you know, politically motivated and driven crime, you know, facilitated and promoted through the music and the corporate structure of the prison system that also lobbies for political decisions that benefit this system. So I wrote, you know, I didn't write that down, but, you know, I wrote about that. You know, I would buy properties that had, you know, access to farmlands or that were fertile, rich soil where you could farm and where I could also build orphanages on with an extension of temple-like school systems that would educate the children on body, mind, and soul, you know, emotional intelligence and the development of their purpose, their vision, their goals, their dreams, their imaginings, and financial literacy so that they could, you know, go about living a very fruitful and abundant life in which they could also benefit society. You know what I'm saying? The teaching of the arts and crafts, sciences, and all the little things and great things that will help them in overcoming a lot of the generational and, you know, worldly problems that we're seeing today. And I just expanded on that like heavily. And as I was reading it to her, she was like, she was just into it. She, you know, but after that, I left my sister's house on my way to train. Did some evening training today. Did legs and chest at the gym. And it's funny because as soon as my mother picked up my niece, right before I left my sister's house, my younger niece called me, my 7-year-old niece. And I was like, what's good, Selena? And she's like, what you doing? And I'm like, I'm at Kayla's. And she's like, So I was like, yo, Selena, do me a favor. Go find a blank piece of paper and something to write with. She's like, for what? Don't worry. Go get it. I'm going to tell you after you get back. Had her do the same thing. I was like, Selena, write as many things as you can imagine that you want to do in life, whatever it is. You want to be a YouTuber, you want to drive cars, you want to be a dancer, a singer, a writer, an actress, you want to make movies, you want to write kids books, you want to talk to kids, you want to talk to people, you want to be a teacher, whatever it is, Selena, let your imagination go. There's nothing stopping you. Believe that the world is yours and you're here to do as you wish with your life. You want to be a mom, a grandma, an auntie, a good sister, whatever it is, write it down. She was about to go on the computer. I was like, close the computer and put the paper on top of the computer and write. I want you to use your imagination. Don't look nothing up. Just imagine and write. Imagine and write. So then I told her, I was like, you know what? And I'm going to talk. Call me back once you're done. I'm about to go to the gym. All right? I'm going to ride my bike. No shit. She called me back like 10 minutes later. I'm riding my bike to the gym. So I'm on the phone riding my bike talking to her. She's like, I'm done, Sosa. I'm like, let's hear what you got. What you got? And she just started going through the list. You know what I'm saying? And I was just, and then, you know, Selena's a little different. Selena's very intellectual. Selena goes like, Sosa, why'd you have me write this? I was like, I had you write it, and I had Haley write it today as well. And I've had Dawson and Flady write it. And it's like, but why? It's like, because I want you guys to grow up being able to use your imagination. I want you guys to grow up being able to believe that you can do and that you can have whatever it is that you put your mind to so long as you're willing to work for it. It's like, there's a lot of people in this world that they don't know how to use their imagination, Selena. They're starving for dreams. They're starving for knowledge. And I don't want you guys to ever think that, you know, life is boring. I want you to be able to use your imagination and then to go out and, you know, live with a purpose and with vision and with dreams. I was like, do you think your uncle has imagination? And she was like, yeah. And then she was like, no. And it's like, don't question your answer. Don't question yourself. You know. It's like, I'm always doing things outside the box. That's why I have you guys do everything that I'm learning. I do my best to teach you guys. And so, you know, the message is, you know, do as you would have. Walk your talk. You know, whatever it is that you preach, walk that message, live that message to the T. Our children are in need of it. I think it was Confucius that said, give me a child for 7 years and I will show you the man. And Lao Tzu that said, if your vision is for a few months, then plant vegetables. Is for 10 years, then plant some fruiting trees. But if your vision, if what you desire, it's for over 100 years. Educate the children first. We keep trying to teach old dogs new tricks instead of teaching the new pups, the young pups, you know, how to do what it is that we wish the adults would do. At the age of 10, I received an ass whooping by my grandmother for going to milk the cows by myself when she told me to find somebody, and I couldn't find this somebody. So eventually, after looking for this somebody for, you know, what may have seemed like hours, I went off by myself and I tried to do my best. You know, I did the whole nine. Got the cow, tied her up, you know, tied up the feet, let the little the calf come. Drink off the tit, milked it as best as I can. I probably got like half a gallon. From a cow that would give like 3 to 5 gallons of milk, I only got like half a gallon, maybe 1 gallon of milk out, right? I'm 10 years old. I don't got the strength to milk a cow, probably, you know. But, you know, I had learned from my grandfather. My grandfather always, you know, always, he was always about it. If somebody wanted to learn, he would teach. So I get home. I give my grandmother the half a gallon or whatever it was of milk. And she's like, where's the rest of it? I told her I couldn't find so-and-so, so I went by myself. She whooped my ass. And, you know, as I'm crying, you know, I'm like, I thought to myself, I want to know what adults are not telling me, what they don't want me to know, and what I shouldn't know. That was the first time that I can recall, you know, desiring knowledge, desiring wisdom, desiring understanding, comprehension, prudence. You know what I'm saying? A level of, you know, knowing that will grant me the competence to do what it is that is required of me and that is necessary of me in life so that I can make as little mistakes as possible. I forgot about that desire until I was about 29. Even after my psychedelic experience, I still didn't recall that. It was only later, maybe two or three years after, that I was like, wow, when I was this young, I wanted knowledge, understanding. And look at me now, 31, 21 years later. And now I share that same knowledge and understanding and wisdom and whatever it is that I can with as many children as possible, whether they are toddlers and I'm talking visions and dreams and destinies into them when I see them, whether it is a simple visual contact or words expressed. Or with my nieces and my nephews, you know? Been around my nieces since one was like 2 years old and the other one was only 6 months old. And around my nephews since one was seven and the other one 11. And every moment, you know, though I've messed up, you know, though I came out of the military with a very strong character, with a very strong personality, and, you know, a very overinflated ego, and I didn't know how to express myself without being in a state of rage or dissatisfaction with what was going on, I always tried my best, you know? I would take them out on runs, have them work out in with me, whatever it was that I could do. But now, thankfully, I do have the patience, what I believe might be some wisdom, you know, that I can offer, the temperance, the peace of mind, the drive to actually, you know, wanna leave something that is of value to them for the rest of their life, whether I live another 30, 60, 90 years, or another day. I know that however long or short the life is, whatever messages I have transplanted into them, you know what I'm saying, will be of a long-lasting impact for the rest of their lives. But still, you know, I always continue to do my best. Because why not? You know, we live every day, but we only die once. So why not live a life in which, you know, even after our death, we may continue to live energetically, spiritually, in the memories of everyone who we had a positive impact on. because they actually want to remember their interaction with us, because the interaction that they had with us was so profound and had so much depth that it gave them insight into their own self. It made them appreciate aspects of themselves that they did not understand how to appreciate, or that they didn't even know was there. And it made them second guess possibly other aspects of themselves that they were maybe holding to too much of a high regard, but which didn't need it at all. Life is dope. This is the beauty of life. You can either live once, or you can live every day and only die once in the physical, but live for eternity, intertwined into time, because you came forth, you developed yourself, you became of value to society, you did the best that you could at every moment in time and in every opportunity that was offered to you. And when you left at the right time. You didn't leave a moment too early or a moment too late. It might have been a tragedy, but it might have been only a tragedy to those that can't recognize how it was a blessing. I don't know. Life is like that. We don't know. We're born one day, we die another. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the only thing that life promised us. You are going out, fam. This physical vessel does not last forever. It is impossible. No matter how many fairy tales we may read or hear about, this physical vessel deteriorates. Like everything else in nature, it deteriorates. There is a time to every season. And these physical vessels of blood, flesh, and bone only have so many spring, summers, winters, and fall before they're no more. So live a good life. Live your best life. Be of value. Develop your body. Eat good. Do good. Speak good. Think good. Meditate on all those things that are, you know, beautiful, lovely, joyful, graceful, empowering, nurturing, that fill you with courage, confidence, honor, integrity, commitment, a level of self-discipline, unseen, love, compassion, truth, understanding, wisdom. Richness. Why would anybody else want anything else other than these great things that actually fill you with the warmth and burning passions that actually do fulfill and do uplift not just thyself, but all those around you? Everywhere you go, walk with an aura of gratitude and grace and humility and self-confidence. Not an arrogant pride, a humble pride. Understanding that everybody else around you is capable of the same things that you are now doing. But always seeking to be your very best self. Not better than fulanito de tal or so-and-so, but better than you. And to have fun every step of the way. To enjoy the experience, the journey, the path. the circus of life, this grand comedy of the great comedian, the All, Almighty. That is each and every one of us. Either than that, since ain't nobody out here but me, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna cut it short. It ain't nothing but love. And these things are gonna continue to go up into the tube until further notice. Be the scholar and also be the warrior. Remove every bit of cowardice from within you. Every bit of self-pity, every bit of doubt, every insecurity that lies within you, tackle it with confidence and courage and a warrior's tenacity. You know what I'm saying? To do the right thing, especially when nobody's watching. You may falter from here and there. Never take it too personal to where you stop doing or stop seeking to do the right thing. You are capable of integrity, of honor, of endurance, of being knowledgeable and just, decisive, enduring, disciplined. Believe it. You don't have to see it. Believe it. Until it is seen. Until you make it possible. Through your consistent actions. Through your persistence, your perseverance, despite the obstacles. But despite the trials and errors. At the end of the day, all that we have promised is death. So why not live a good life worth, you know? If we are capable of remembering in death. One of meaning that gives others around us meaning. So that they remember us for something more than just having come through and been an okay individual. Great dude said, yo, a lot of people are comfortable with mediocrity. Just make sure that that ain't you. Believe in your ability and capacity to do something greater than what others think you can or should be doing. Never settle. Never settle. Doesn't mean that you can't have inner peace, but don't ever settle for mediocrity. Don't never settle for just okay. Be better. Be great. Other than that, ain't nothing but love. Y'all continue to have a great evening and a great rest of your life in this conundrum that we call life. All right? One.